12 years ago, of course, this all started in my house in Paramaribo. Mm-hmm. And so as time went by, and we did a very big rescue in 2012, where we moved almost 200 animals. And then a lot of animals got stuck in my house, the small ones. And I suddenly, because of people knowing about the work you do, then suddenly you get more telephone calls and more people who want to help.
Yeah.
And then we realized that we couldn't continue anymore in my house. I had a big garden, but for animals to be able to be rehabilitated, they need a natural environment. Mm. And so that's when we decided that we needed to move to a place where there's more natural forest.
So how many sloths did you have in your house back then with the big rescue of 200?
Well, there were 17 babies, and there were two females. One female was wounded, and the other female we put inside because we weren't very sure about how she was doing, and also to help the little ones. So at night you would see that all the little ones would sit on top of these females.
It was
very funny.
Yeah,
very funny to see. And they were very, how shall I say, they were very nice to the little ones. Because afterwards I've not really seen that happening. We've tried sometimes with babies to put them with big females so that they would have a surrogate mother, but we found it doesn't work that well. No, but so we were very lucky with the one, the two animals we had then, that they were very nice and allowed the little ones to sit with them.
Why were there so many sloths? Was it a deforestation?
No, it was, yeah, it was a 7-hectare plot of land that was being deforested by butcher for pasture. Mm-hmm. And we knew that there were 13 animals there because the chairman of the Animal Protection Society had seen the animals. And so basically what happened is that she called me. She said, oh, they're going to deforest. Do you want to really get them out? I said, yes. And so we contacted Nature Conservation Division. We contacted the owner. And so we all came together. And then what was supposed to have been a rescue of 13 animals became a rescue of almost 200 animals. Yeah. It was very funny because the game warden that helped us and one of my volunteers, on the first day, I think, or the second day, they made a calculation. They said, well, we're going to have maybe 160 animals, just based on what we had found in one day. I said, no, it's not possible. I said, there are only 13. But that was probably more like me being like, I really don't want...
Yeah,
to know that there's going to be more than 13.
Thinking,
13 was a lot already for
me.
It was more than I'd ever seen together.
Mm-hmm.
And so, so then that happened. We were working for almost 2 months with the operator of the excavator. And he was really nice about it. He didn't push the trees in such a way that the animals would die, because the owner really also wanted us to do this.
Oh, okay.
So that was a good,
very
was a good collaboration.
Still sad, but...
Yeah. But, because a lot of people ask me, why are you doing this? Why are they deforesting? I said, well, you know, this is private land. This is the best we can do.
Mm-hmm.
It's to save the animals.
Yeah.
Because I cannot tell the guy not to deforest. it's impossible.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, so it was the best we could do, and we did, and I think we gained a lot of experience because of that. We also took the opportunity to do some research, to measure the animals, etc. Take some blood samples to do genetic sampling as well. And so it was also a learning experience that
yeah.
will, in the end, help to better protect them,
yeah.
to protect these populations. Mm-hmm.